There are people who start with shortcuts. They are very, it's very hard for them to have a computer which is very new and without shortcuts. They'll be very slow to edit. When you get used to edit without shortcuts, it will be very annoying for you to do shortcuts. So it's actually a path, same as you driving. When you drive, you have your own style of driving. Either you drive fast, you drive crazy, or you drive safely. So it's the same way. You learn something, you'll do it throughout it. So when you learn editing, learn in a proper way, that it'll be easy for you and also for the others who are working with you. Because we are not going to just end up working alone. So how many of you got the files? 3, 4 now. Select the files, which is the correct version. I think on this, almost everything is correct, but some of them are not good. Some of them we cut in the middle, because you guys were practicing. So check if the quality, because I think in one angle we have 3 or 4 shots, same shots for 3 angles. We don't need 3 shots, take only one shot. So all what we need is one close-up, one mid, and we had a wide. Or maybe in between these two. You just need 3 shots. The reason, we're also going to use some B-rolls. Just mark clip number 2, clip number 3, clip number 5, clip number 8. Just mark the clip name. Select the files, but watch the whole thing. Watch the whole thing and analyze the files, which is good, which is not good, which can be used in this video. So we need 3 main shots or 4 shots maximum, where you will have a close up, mid and a wide, or in the middle of any of these. So inside this video folder,
first we have to copy
means, yeah, make the structure, bring all the files under footages, videos. Under this you can have selected files in one folder and the rest in the other folders. You can say archive. Don't delete this at the moment. Keep it. Even if you don't want the files, just keep it. Take only the ones which you want to work. Leave the others because it might help you later. We prepare. Adobe Premiere is an industrial software at the moment. They are using for big productions, feature films, small films, independent filmmakers, everyone is using this. So it's a valid and very good software to start working with. Not even to start, like you can continue, you can be pro in editing after some time on this. And this software is very huge. It has a lot of options, which I think I'm still using 50% of it. 50% of it, even I don't know. Still learning, because they keep on updating every single day. So there are new options comes, there are new technique comes, and we will have to learn by doing it. The more you edit, the time you spend on editing suites will increase your editing speed and editing skills. It's like the pilots. The more you fly, you get hours. So it's the same way, the more you edit, you get more hours of editing. How many of you remember codec, format, and other elements that we studied last week? Everyone. Correct? You remember that. Now, before you open the software, you have to be familiar with what is the video format you are working on. What is the format we are having it at the moment?
MP4.
We are working on a
MP4.
And what is the audio format we are working
on? WAV.
It's a WAV. Everyone is clear with that? You have the audio files also?
No.
Download that from the group. Send it in the group.
You have like in your pen drive? Do you have in your pen drive?
It's in the WhatsApp. So scan WhatsApp.
The WAV is in the WeShare. You can go to the. I sent the link.
Yeah, I have it
here. Or maybe if you have, we can
go
copy.
Go to WhatsApp web. Scan the code. Take. The, you know. So get that as well. So we are working on MP4. And WAV. What is the frame rate we are working on?
24?
How did you know 24?
Because we shoot it in 24?
We shot in 24.
Yeah, shot.
If not, how do you find it?
We can click it
on. If it is Windows, you will right click on the file,
yeah.
Go to properties and check what is the frame rate. Frames per second. What is the resolution? Can you tell me both of these?
No,
check
the
file. Right click.
1080p.
Go to properties. If it is Mac, go
full
to
HD,
get
1080p.
24
frames. Full HD means 1080p. Right?
24 frames.
Let's check it.
What is the resolution?
1080p, right?
Now, what you are seeing is 1080p,
yes.
Which is full HD.
Yeah.
But we shot these files on 4K. The reason we downgraded or converted into full HD because these computers will not handle 4K footage. So now this is the reason you need to know the properties of any video or audio to find out the capability of your computer or the system you are working on. If this computer will support 4K or not. It will not support, then we will have to get back to full HD, which is decent and good enough to learn. It's not very bad quality. So we are working on a full HD, which is 1080 frame resolution.
Yeah.
And we are working on a 24 frames per second.
Yes.
What is the audio properties? We are working on MP3. What is the bitrate?
Bitrate 316 kbps.
Three?
Yeah, the audio, yeah. 316 kbps.
Okay.
And the studio channels. And
six channel stereo?
Yes. And 48,000 hertz, kilohertz. This is audio. This is video.
No, we are not using this audio. We are using what I sent. Oh,
no, yes, but in this video, we are just talking.
No, I'm talking about the original audio.
Oh, no. This is the video one.
Tell me the original, I think you have it.
Okay.
Where
do I get this here? How do I copy it? How do I copy that?
Where is the software?
The software, okay, I'll show you.
The bitrate is 320. 320
kbps. This is the software.
320.
Okay. Stereo.
Stereo. Channel 2.
Stereo. Okay.
Then
stereo is done.
The sample rate is 48,000.
48,000. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. For videos, if you're exporting audios, it's always 48. So, audio engineers, or even if you download from internet, you will get on this rate. So, it's not a problem. It's by default. There is nothing that you have to change. This is by default. This is I'm teaching so that you can understand if you face a problem while you're editing, why it's not working. But these ones are by default, it's there. When you convert to full HD, 24 frames, when you get the audio properties, this is by default. You don't change anything. Leave it the way it is. I'm teaching you this to get a knowledge. If you face a problem while you are editing saying unsupported format, then I don't want you to ask a question, what is format? Now we know what is the format, what is the codec? So we can solve this problem later. Okay? So now we will have to work on a full HD sequence. Because the videos are full HD, if you try to edit on 4K, you will have to resize the frame. Then what happens when you resize it?
Yeah, so 2004K. Yeah.
Okay, now let's say full HD is 1920 1080.
Yes.
If you have to work on 4K,
I'll show you.
Now you will have to resize, which is
yes.
bigger than this.
Yeah.
I think which is 2000 2040 2160, I guess.
Yes, 2000.
So you are increasing the size. So when you increase the pixels, what happens?
And then you can
you
see the more data.
Quality.
Yeah.
So never ever edit a small file into a bigger resolution sequence. Edit on the same resolution as the video itself. Let's say that you are working on this full HD.
How about if you have a video that you need to
I'm coming there. So if you have these videos recorded on full HD, but the versions you have downloaded in the internet by the YouTube is 720. Actually, 720 is going to be smaller than this. But in this case, you have no option. You have to resize and make it big, because our main A-roll footage is
1080.
You will lose quality. If not, you will have to find full HD clips from the internet. Clear enough? Clear?
Yeah.
All?
Yes.
We will work on full HD sequence. Now open the software. Adobe Premiere. Just empty screen.
Me.
1, 2, 3, and Santosh. We have only empty screen.
Right.
We have the name here.
Yes.
We have the this one, right?
Yeah.
We have something there. And everything else is empty. And you see a button here?
Hmm.
Correct?
Yes.
Okay. Stay like that. What do you see? Okay, you won't see that because she has a 2021
yeah.
version. So this window will change on every version. Okay? Now here, this is how a 2021 version will look like. And closing, minus, maximize, everything is on the other side. For you guys, you will have it on this side. So the layout might be different on different computers. Don't worry about it. As long as the software is open and just see a blank screen, leave it like that. How many of you see a home screen like this with the project name or something, new project? How many of you see this? One. Only one. The reason?
The project.
And you?
Yeah.
And because of the reason, these two computers have been not used much. The other computers, the people, those you used before, they closed it. So it's not going to come back. The people who worked on this, they never closed it. So it's there. Understand that?
Previous project.
The previous project, it's coming up here. For whoever has it empty, it doesn't have previous project. It's clean now. So what you have to do is, you have to create a new project. Okay? For that, there are multiple ways to do it. Whoever has this window, you can click the new project on the top. Whoever doesn't have any of these, go to File, New Project. Keep doing it while I'm explaining it. What are the things you see?
Name, location.
Name, location.
General, then the other tabs like general, scratch, disk,
in so sense. On new project. Name, location. Correct?
Yes.
This is empty here. Okay?
Yes.
And you have some options here. And you have okay and cancel.
Yes.
Do you have anything else?
No.
You don't have anything else?
Yeah, the bottom.
Correct or wrong? What is the window on this side says?
There's no window. Nothing.
No, that.
Not yet?
No.
This one, right?
There is no.
Okay. What window is that? Keep it like that. So now, what is the project name? As we named before on the big folder.
Yeah. Bounce.
So fill that with the project name. So this will be the project name every time you open. You close it today, you come tomorrow, even if you want to open it, you will see it on the recent project as bounce. You click that, the same project will open back. So when you name it, name made properly. I have a habit of naming it, I don't know if you want to follow it. I always name it with capital, underscore, I'll put the date. If I'm editing the second video on the same tag, I will do this underscore 01 underscore then the date. This is just to make it more easier to open the same project back. Just if you want to follow it, if not, you can simply leave it. Keep it as bounce and the location. You have option here to change, correct?
Yeah.
Click that, it will open up a window.
Yes.
So the location has to go to where? To the big folder, project, Adobe Premiere. You remember the big folder you created?
Mm.
Footages, project, and the export. So now footage is finished. Now we are jumping to the second folder called project. So you go to the project, inside project you have different softwares, as I said, Premiere, After Effects, Audition.
Yes.
So now select Premiere and give OK. If you try to change anything, sometimes the computer will start bugging you. You will hit your computer after some time. If you try to change the RAM speed, which is this. See this?
Mm.
Playback engine, software only. So now the RAM will use all the power to run the computer. If you change that, what happens? It will divide into other programs which is running and the computer will get stuck. So don't change anything rather than these two. You will put the name, put the location correctly where you want to save the project, give OK. Simple as that, give OK now.
Yes. I don't know where it is coming.
Okay,
yeah.
What happened now? What happened here? You have some complete new blank window. Correct?
Yeah.
Correct? View, sequence, windows, you have that?
Yeah.
And you have names here and an X. Correct?
Yep.
Project name. Next to that, what do you have?
Effect.
No. What I'm saying is
media browser.
Hmm?
You have something called project name.
Mm-hmm.
And you have any name here?
Media browser.
There's no name?
Yes, the project name.
The name that you saved.
Yes.
Effects?
Yeah.
You have that. And next to that you have effects.
Yeah.
Media browser. What else is
libraries?
FN.
And
okay.
The arrow.
These are just windows. Okay. We are now in the project window. Actually, these are just the tabs. What do you have here?
Source.
Program.
Timeline.
Here you will not see. To see, you have to expand. Actually, name is there, but you will not see because it's small. So this is the magic layout we're going to work. For Manisha, you will have project here, and you have the program, and you have the timeline. Because of the layout, I'm working on that before it will save. So when you work on this layout, now you have the option to move the files, move the windows here and there. You can simply drag the effects and put it there.
Okay.
You can change according to how it's good for you. Because this lap is connected to two monitors, the way it's looking is different from you guys. But don't get confused. See that the layout is different here because the other window is on the next monitor. But it's the same. So don't worry about the layout. If you have the project here, it's the same function. If the places are changed, Not a problem at all. How many of you can see this computer? Can you see this computer?
Mm-hmm.
Can you see?
Yes.
Now here, I have the project, correct?
Mm-hmm.
I can drag and drop it there. Now project window is here.
Mm-hmm.
But it's the same function. The function will never change. But as default, it comes here. And these are just tabs. You can move around. Click and move around. And if you don't need that, you need more space, you will write on, you will click, just simple click on these three lines. Close. Media browser, close panel. If you don't need, you can simply close. This is the history of all the work that you are doing. It will come there. Okay?
Okay.
So the purpose of every window is very, very important. If you miss this, it will take ages for you to understand the software. This is the very basic step of Premiere, but very important. What does project window does inside the software for us is keeping all the files there. This is basically like just a folder. It's just like a window for folder. So you will have all your footages, sounds, images, all effects you want to use, timelines, sequence, everything will come here. When you are working, if you want to see the original file, you can simply find it here. So project window is like the bank. You could say it's a bank. Everything saves there. Saves means everything is visible there. So now, how to bring the files here? There are a couple of ways that you can do it. Shortcut, Control plus I, which is import. In Mac, Command I. In Windows, Control plus I. If not, double click on this empty window. Just double click and it will come. If not, go to Files, Import. Okay, now actually go to Files, everyone click File. Can you see option called Import?
Yeah.
But don't click. Just go to File. Can you see this option?
Yeah.
And next to Import, you have CTRL plus I.
Yeah.
So every option in the menu will give you the shortcut as well. I said it because I remember. When you do it, you will be also learning more shortcuts. How to find shortcuts? Next to every option, you will have the shortcut written there. So if you are in the file, you can see on this side, on the window, all the shortcuts are mentioned here. For all the options on this side. For Mac and Windows both. Okay?
Yeah.
So now just click outside. Just click somewhere here. One click. Okay, now the window is gone, right?
Yeah.
So double click here on the project window. What happens? There's a folder comes. Close that. Go to File. Press Import.
Same thing.
Same thing happens, right?
Yeah.
Close the window. Control I. Press Control I.
Yeah,
what
close.
Happens?
Same thing.
So these are a couple of ways that you can import footages inside the software. And there is one more easy way.
Drag directly, right?
Just go to the folder,
yeah.
Drag and drop the file.
Yeah.
But we will not do that right here in the class. This is when you are pro, not now. Because it might give you more confusion. You will drag the wrong folder. You will think it's something else and you will drag. Because you remember the way we created the folder organized? So if you drag the wrong folder, everything will come inside. And it will make the software slow. At the moment, use the shortcut or double click or go to File and import the file, which is easier for you.
Okay.
I would prefer you start using shortcuts. It will make the workflow faster. Okay?
Yep.
So, do one of those options and open the window to bring the files.
Okay.
You can do Control I, you can do File Open, File Import, or you can use the double click on this. So when the window is open, tell me when the window is open.
Yep.
All? I have 10 here, I can't hear.
Yeah. Yes.
Yes, very good. So if we have a window here, now we again have the options. It's like a folder. Now go to the same footage folder that we created.
Yes.
Navigate to the footage folder that we created. And what you will bring inside is only the selected videos.
All the videos, all the five.
Yeah. If you click the folder called selected.
All four?
All four.
All four. All four.
Okay.
You don't have to, you can either select all, drag and select all.
Yeah.
If not, just select the folder and you will have option to import folder.
Yes.
Correct?
Yeah.
You have import folder and cancel.
Yeah.
No, no, don't bring the B-roll at the moment.
Only selected four
clips.
Yeah.
Don't bring the B-roll. Because we're going to do something else, something interesting.
Already did it.
Okay. Yeah. So do you have four clips imported?
Yeah.
Mayur?
Yeah.
Is it?
Yes.
First one. Okay. If you get that, what does it mean?
It means
nothing.
Yeah.
It's the same file, but the viewing option is different.
Yes.
So down, you have one box and one line, like three lines.
Yeah.
If you switch that, you can go back to both.
Yes.
Try doing it.
The list of view.
Okay.
Yeah.
Good. So I prefer to keep them in thumbnail mode, which is box.
They say icon view and list of view.
Yeah, icon view and list of view. Keep it on icon view.
Okay.
Which is easy for you to see the thumbnail.
Yeah.
Actually, here, So it's easy for you to see, okay, this is the clip. You don't have to every time double click and play. You can see. Now, simply move the mouse on the top of the clip. What happens?
Video moves.
It's nice? Or not?
Yeah.
Is it nice or not?
Yeah.
It happens?
Yeah.
Very good. So when you have that, you also have a small play button there that you can just drag and see. And there is something else down here, like a line in the marker.
Yeah.
Try to move this, what happens?
Yeah, adjust. We can adjust size.
You can increase the size of the thumbnail if you want to see it clear. Correct?
Yeah.
Cool?
Yes.
Everyone happy?
Yeah.
Seeing your footage?
Yes.
Nice. So now you have the footages here. Four footages. And on this side, you have something like a bin, like a folder.
Yes.
Yeah. Do we have?
Yeah.
And we have a basket, like a dustbin.
Mm-hmm.
We have?
Yes.
So if you select it, let's say that you don't need this file, you can simply drag and drop to the bin, like you throw it on the dustbin. If not, you can select and click the dustbin, it will delete from there. If not, right click and see the option called clear.
Yeah.
Don't click it, just see it.
Yeah.
You have option called clear.
Yes.
If not, very simple, select the file, delete on your keyboard.
Yes.
If you want to remove the files.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yep.
Cool?
Yep.
Okay, nice. So now we have the files, we know how to do that. Now we're going to organize inside the software. Now we have this four clips which is belongs to the A roll folder.
Yes.
So select four and drag and drop into the bin. Not the dustbin, the other one. Like a folder.
Okay.
What happens?
Is make a folder.
It'll create a folder. Rename into
A-roll. Yeah.
So yeah, now you know all the A-roll shot is inside that bin.
Already we did. Right,
select.
A-roll.
Yep.
Double click that.
Yeah, we can see it.
What happens? It will come back again as the project window.
Yeah.
But the window name says A role.
Yeah.
It will not say you project. Correct?
They say bounce project slash A role.
Yeah, so there is a
under,
slash, then A role.
Yeah.
Correct?
Yeah.
On the three lines, close that for now.
Okay.
Close panel.
Okay.
Click the three line and close panel. If you are not following up with me, please tell me, I'll come to you.
Yes, we close it.
Three lines.
Yeah,
that now
close.
This is under. So I teach you how to do A roll. Now by yourself, you have to do a folder code.
B roll.
Please do it.
Close panels.
Okay, very good. that you did that. Now, if you lose any of these panels and you can't find it, how do you get it back? Let's say that by mistakenly you close panel of the project. How do you get it back?
From Windows.
Any panel on this software is closed and you want to get it back.
Yeah.
Don't worry, don't panic. The project is not deleted. Project is not gone somewhere. It's everything is on the same place because we saved it on the correct way. The only thing you have to do is just go to the option called Windows and select the name and it will come back.
Yep.
Windows.
Or also they have like the editing one. If you click it and then you will see it.
Go to Windows, you will see all the panels which is inside the software.
Yeah.
And if you drag these, go here and there and mess the whole thing, still don't worry. Go to Windows, you have an option called Reset Workshop. Do you have it?
Yeah.
Reset Workshop and it will come back to default. Change anything, delete, close, do whatever you want, just go back to Reset and it will come back to normal.
From when you get Reset?
From Windows, Windows Workshop, Reset.
Reset to workspace. Save layout, yeah.
Yeah, in Windows it's Workspace, huh? Reset.
All plus Shift plus 0.
The
shortcut key. This is it? Yes.
So now we learn to open the software, open a new project, import the files. The next thing that we have to learn next week is opening a timeline where you will edit your footages. Cut, in, out, change footages, put the sound, sync the music and the video. We will learn that on the next class. But today we learned how to organize, how to backup, how to organize the folder, how to select the folder, and how to create a new project, how to import files. All good?
Yep.
Any doubt till that?